so central to this story?
Well, because what's come out now, Maria, is that he has been the go-between Christopher Steele. So once Christopher Steele was terminated as a source for doing all things like talking to the media at the behest of Glenn Simpson. So remember, he was working for Glenn Simpson, Fusion GPS, who were working for the Clinton campaign. Christopher Steele was fired. A lot of this information wasn't shared with the FISA court, especially the fact that Christopher Steele was desperate that Donald Trump not become president. After that happened, Bruce Ohr, one of the top lawyers in the Department of Justice, kept continually meeting and providing information from Christopher Steele to who? The FBI. This is just madness. The American people need to know it. And I will tell you, like I said in the last segment, the fact that the media is ignoring this is even more of a reason that we're going to have more information than usual declassified. We're going to have, I think, an unprecedented amount of information declassified because the media is just not covering this topic. And I'll just kind of close it with this. Don't forget that Bruce Ohr's wife, Nellie Ohr, who also will have to be interviewed soon, she also was working for Fusion GPS, working for the Clinton campaign. So here you have information flowing from the Clinton campaign, from the Russians, likely, I believe, was handed directly from Russian propaganda arms to the Clinton campaign, fed into the top levels of the FBI and Department of Justice to open up a counterintelligence investigation into a political campaign that has now polluted nearly every top official at the DOJ and FBI over the course of the last couple of years.
Well, that is what is so extraordinary.
And quite frankly, it's what you kind of see in this part of the world where I'm at now.
Right.
I think it's like the Speaker of the House, Paul Ryan, said several months ago, is the Department of Justice and FBI need to decide whether or not they want to be part of the cleanup crew or the cover-up crew. And so right now, I just want to be clear, they are providing slowly, but they are providing documentation. But we're going to have all of this information declassified, and we need an investigation into these top-level people as to how somebody concocted the idea that it's okay to take information from one political campaign and use it to open up an investigation on the other political on somebody else's opposing political party.
Right.
It's absolutely nuts.
And you've said many times on this program that there was zero evidence, official evidence, available to launch an investigation into collusion between Donald Trump and the Russians. There was no evidence. It was all based on that unverified dossier. Real quick, I'll go one step further in terms of trusting the FBI and the DOJ again. That's not going to happen until there is accountability. Will there be accountability? Will we see prosecutions?
The only way there can be accountability is one step at a time, and it deals with full and complete transparency, full sunlight on as many of the documents that don't endanger national security, which, you know, from our committee members, we've sent a letter to the president. We don't believe that you're going to jeopardize any sources or